ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स। अब तक सम हेप्टिक प्रॉब्लम्स, लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स। अगेन वी आर रिजॉइंड अवर सेल्फ यस्टरडे, डे बिफोर यस्टरडे वी हैव कंक्लूडेड द लेक्चर ऑन स्ट्रेटेजिक मैनेजमेंट एंड वी हैव स्टडीड द प्रोसेस ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजिक मैनेजमेंट। नाउ विल गो फर्दर इन डिटेल्स विद द स्ट्रेटेजिक मैनेजमेंट। व्हाट इज स्ट्रेटेजिक मैनेजमेंट? ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एवर फेसेस द अनसर्टेनिटी एंड हैज टू फेस द स्ट्रेटेजिक वर्क, इट्स अ कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस। Means whenever the organization functioning, it is a continuous process, and every manager is going for success and he is going for getting a achieving the goals. But sometimes what happens, because of certain uncertainties, we are not carry out the work, and to derived output is not possible. At that time we have to think in different way and we have to formulate another strategy, that is another course of action. So here it's a continuous process that a manager has to go for the strategic management. Hence it is important. The strategic management is a cyclic process, starts with the environmental analysis and goes for strategic control, and again it begins with the environmental analysis. As we have seen earlier, that strategic analysis, then strategic choice, implementation, and third is a evaluation process. This is the process of strategic management. So here it's a cyclic process. It starts with the analysis of the problem, then correcting the right such path, course of action, that is choosing, then I'm implementing the things, and after implementation, evaluation. It's a cyclic process. Hence, and from cyclic again it goes to analysis. Strategic management draws the inputs from the various functional areas of management. It integrates the various areas of management. Hence, cross-sectional team members work together and organization enjoys the benefits of synergy. What is synergy effect? Here, in this case, all the departments of the organizations, finance, marketing, HR, operation, production, supply chain management, even all the departments, international business management, they are working all together. So it formulates the synergy. Cross-sectional area means different areas of the organizations that we are working together, and it forms a synergy effect. Synergy effect means better effect. We are working on same platform. Next slide. Member of the organization visualize the overall position of the firm standing, and they can plan for the competitive advantage of their firms. They encourage commitment of the key executives of strategic plans. Here what happens? Members of organization visualize the overall position of the firm. Means before making any strategic decision, we must understand what is the strategic position of our firm, where we are. Means we have planned certain output, and to get output or to derive certain output, what is our strategic position? You must understand. And the members in the group, they can visualize where we are, because target is given to everyone. And to attain the targets, everybody knows what is our position. So in order to increase the efforts, or in order to concentrate on your efforts, or in order to keep your efforts steady, the members of the organization, they are visualizing the strategic position. It helps, strategic management helps in visualizing the position of organization. Strategic ensure the success of firms with the change in environment. Organization can modify their strategy in accordance with the change in environment. For example, firm changes their strategic strategy with the change of government ordinance and policies. Sometimes what happens, the government changes, or some that is strategic bodies, strategic, we can't say strategic, but they are certain controlling bodies, they change certain decisions. Suppose in case of government policies, that government is changing certain policies, that implementation of GST, execution of GST, then other sales tax and other things. When the government orders the things, then again we have to shift our plan, we have to make the changes. So the firm changes, the firm has to change the strategies according to the government, because after all, government or that body, the statutory body, they are giving us a permission to run in the environment. Hence, their policies and ordinances are very important. So firm have to change their strategies according to the government. Next. Now here we see the historical strategic management. Means how the strategic management is taking place. In short, I can explain you that strategic management is the process where the managers are adopting the alternate course of action. If the things are going in the right direction, there is no requirement of employing any kind of the strategy. Suppose, for example, there is no competition in the market. You are the sole businessman or you are sole person who is producing certain commodities. So you don't have any kind of competition. At that time, strategies are not required. But if there is a lot of competition, then in order to sustain ourselves, in order to compete with the environment, we require the strategies. So here, strategic management starts when the problem occurs, right? We can say that if you are immune free, if you don't have problem, you don't have any kinds of the diseases, then what? You need not to consult any doctor or go to any doctor. But even when you face the problems, you had certain disease, you had some problem, your immune system is getting disturbed, then you have to consult the doctor. Here in the same way, early in my lectures, I told you that managers are like a doctors. When there is a problem with the system, what we have to do? We have to consult. We have to formulate the strategies. We have to take the help of strategic management and we have to control the organizations. So historic development of strategic management, how it is to be developed. Then first, phase number one, means when we had a problem, how will go step by step? In the first phase, basic financial planning. You have to first go for the financial planning. Where, how you go for the financial planning? You have to operational control, then annual budget and functional focus. These are the three instruments by which we can go for the basic financial planning. We have to first plan for the finance. Second, next, phase two, forecast-based planning. Forecast-based planning means more effective planning for growth. We are a manager. We can plan, we can forecast. And according to that, we have to go for the outputs. Hence, the main important work of manager is to decision-make. To make the decisions, he has to make the forecast. So forecast-based planning means everywhere you have to forecast the things. You have to plan the things. For planning, you have to give the forecast. More effective planning for growth. If you are giving forecast, forecast means we are giving target to ourselves. What is to be achieved? Environmental analysis. Environmental analysis, you have to see the environment. Who comes in the environment? Competitors are coming in the environment. Government policies are coming in the environmental analysis. You have to analyze the environment. That is forecast. According to that, then we can forecast the things. Multi-year plans. What we have to do? We have to go for the previous year's multi-year plan. And how we are achieved the targets. Means for last to last year, what we have actually done, that you have to go for the multi-year plan. We have to go for the multi-year planning plans. Then strategic allocation of resources. This is a very important aspect, allocation of resources. Because what is management? Allocation, utilization of proper resources. So allocation of resources means how optimum amount of resources should be allocated so that we will have the organizations will have the proper output. Means minimum resources and maximization of profit. It comes in the second phase, that is forecast-based planning. Next. Third is externally oriented planning. In externally oriented planning phase three, I told you that who comes in the external environment. External environment, internal environment, these are very important aspects. When we do SWOT analysis, that is strength, weakness, and opportunities and threat. SWOT analysis, strengths and weakness, these are the internal. Opportunities and threats, they are external parts of external environment. So external oriented planning means increasing response to the marketing competition. You have to study this in phase three. Increasing response to the marketing competition. What is the response of customers in lot of multiple competition through the situation and competitive assessment. Competitive assessment. It is our research department, marketing department. They generally conduct the surveys and they conduct the research in order to find the position of our product and current scenario of the market. They are indulged in all kinds of the activities. Evaluation of strategic alternatives. See, when we have designed any kinds of the product, then we have to find out alternate to sell out the products in the market because there is no option. I have given one example to all the students that the Tata Motors has designed Tata Indica petrol model. When the diesel model started coming in Indian environment, Maruti has brought desire in the market. At that time, it was very difficult for Tata to sell out their petrol Indica cars in Indian environment. So he has not stopped. What he has done, he has sold his Indicas in Europe under the logo Rover. So that is called a strategic alternatives. You must find if your product is failing in certain areas, you must go for the, you must go in other sectors, in other markets to sell the products. Okay, that is called a strategic alternatives, or we can choose another. Now we have so many alternatives that we can go for the online marketing. We are giving discounts, we are giving the promotions, alternate in order to promote our, in order to increase the sales. We have to design the alternate strategies. You have seen that in mobile services, that is mobile services, Airtel, Jio is there, Vodafone is there, Idea is there. Okay, how fast they are just changing their marketing strategies. Why? In order to sustain that, because managers must always go for the strategic alternatives in order to sell out your product in the market and dynamic allocation of resources. I told in earlier also, resource allocation is one of the prime aspect in management because optimum use of resources and maximization of profit. This is the only key for our success. So in phase three, we will go for the external oriented planning. Means what is happening in the environment, we must understand that this study based out of the organization, it is not the internal organization, it is out of organizations, which when our product are in the market. Next. Phase four is strategic management. That orchestration of all resources to create a competitive advantage. Orchestration, what is orchestra? In orchestra, there is a singer, there is a music player, okay? Then there are music players are there, different kinds of players are there, 3 to 4 types of, or sometimes 8 to 10 types of music are being played. So then audio system is there. So when you are synchronizing all these things, you will say, yes, what a good orchestra. Here in this case, whatever the resources, that we are using, okay, after study of internal and external, what we have to do, we have to correlate, we can say that, synchronize all the resources to create a competitive advantage. Strategic management, the main concern of strategic management is to get the competitive advantage over your arch rival. Strategic management is important to get the competitive advantage over arch rival because why we are adopting the strategy? Because we had the problem. We have to go ahead. We have to become a market leader. When we are adopting the strategy, then the aim is to gain the competitive advantage. Proper. Okay. Whatever may be the commodity, you have to be at top. Strategically chosen planning. Strategically chosen planning means planning, but with the help of this study of all the phases. Back. And create. Next. Next. strategically chosen planning. ठीक है अच्छा need for strategic management. What is the importance need? Why strategic management is important? What is the need? Due to change. Change makes planning difficult. It allows firm to take advantage of opportunities provided by the changes in the environment. What is happening? You take the electronics market, or you take FMCG, that is fast moving commodity goods. Electronics market, it's a very flexible market. You can't plan even production also. You can't plan marketing also, because it's dynamically it is changing. Variants are changing, various facilities are getting changed, mobile market, fast moving. Here, the change makes planning difficult. Because of the change, it is very difficult to make a change. If you are producing certain kinds of the product, you will find that next day, some other product is in the market. Okay. If you change the prices, you will find that next day, somebody has on a change the price. Promotional offers, if you see promotion, what promotion that you are giving today, you will find tomorrow somebody is giving. So here in this situation, it is very difficult to change. Due to change makes planning difficult. It allows firm to take advantage of opportunity provided by the changes in the environment. As the environment is getting changed, what we have to do? We have to change up. See, till the time Jio services not active, everybody was moving in the very smooth way. But when Jio came in the market, what happens? Everybody was striving for the existence, because Jio has brought the reformation in communication industries. So here we have to change ourselves. Due to change, provide guidelines. It provides the guidelines to the employers about the organizational expectations from them. This minimizes the gap between job performance and job demands. Okay, what is your performance? What we are doing, and what demands? What is demanded? For that, it provides the guideline. What is to be done? Okay, strategic management is providing the guideline for filling the gap between job performance and job demand. Next. Development of field for research. Strategic management, it's only part of research, because here we have to search and you have to design and redesign the strategies, that is analysis, choose, implementation, control. It's a part of research. So it's development of research, the field for the research. It is a new field, means whatever the problem you are having, that is field for the new research, new inventions. Probability for the better performance. It is suggested that the firms which plan strategically having higher rate of success. Those were, see, now what is happening? That because of the corona, all the lectures are, physical lectures are suspended. Now who is surviving? Who will survive? The organizations are making the bitter changes, that if the physical lectures are not possible, then we have to conduct the lectures online. If you are changing ourselves, then only you will be successful. Otherwise, you have to shut down. Think about the old teachers who doesn't have the access or who doesn't open to the technology. What? They are not able to conduct the lectures. So whenever certain problems, this is the situation. And in situations, how we are surviving? Okay, suppose नदी में बाढ़ आती है. नदी में बाढ़ आने के बाद हम क्या करते हैं? ऐसे नदी से जाते. बट वेन वी आर गोइंग थ्रू अ रिवर, वी नीड नॉट टू स्विम. बट वेन देर इज अ बाढ़, ठीक है, तो व्हाट हैपेंस? देन वी हैव टू स्विम. ठीक है, लाइक वाइज वेन एवर देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम, वी हैव टू गो फॉर द अल्टरनेट्स. कोविड प्रॉब्लम इज देयर, वी आर गोइंग फॉर द अल्टरनेट. सेम वे वेन द मार्केट डिमांड्स सर्टन न्यू इन्वेंशंस प्रॉब्लम्स, देन वी हैव टू गो फॉर द अल्टरनेट्स. And change is the law of nature. We have to change ourselves. It strategically having higher rate of success. Who succeeds, who changes ourselves. Even I told you so many times that Darwin has written the theories of evolution, that he has told that when there is a problem of existence, who will survive, intelligent or strongest? No, neither intelligent nor strongest. Who will survive? Who is adopting the changes? Likewise here, to in order to survive ourselves, organizations are making the changes in their functioning called as strategic. Now, lot of retrenchment and structural changes are going on. Earlier marketing, physical marketing was there, but you right now you can see that mobile marketing is there, internet marketing is there. Even take example of Flipkart, Google and your Amazon, they are selling their products in departmental shops or always, as well as they are selling their products online. So online mode is a new strategic moment. It is a new strategy, that is online marketing is a new strategy in order to reach the customers very fastly. So it's a strategic management. It proves to be a better for the performance. Next. Systematic business decisions. Strategic means step by step. If you are to reach the height or you have to climb certain height, you can't just jump. Yeah, you can't fly. What we have to do, you have to go step by step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 5, 6, 7. Likewise, if you are going 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, then you will be reaching up to destinations. Only 10 minutes are remaining. We'll go first. Systematic business decision, helping in providing information about different business transactions, which helps in systematic business decision step by step. Improve the communication of information from lower level to middle level and top level. Lower, middle and top, middle and lower. Improves the coordination amongst the functional areas. What are the functional areas? Marketing, HR, finance, operation, supply chain management. All will be coordinating with each other to get the synergy effect. Next. It improves the allocation of resources. Already we have discussed. Like resources are very important. It helps the managers in holistic approach. What is holistic approach? Helps the manager in having complete understanding of the company and to have the holistic approach toward the business problems. And that means he will, holistic approach is the such approach where he will be getting all the information. Is it not like that, I am from marketing department, so I know that much. Holistic means overall. Person who is running, who is leading the organization, she will get the holistic approach, that is all information of the organizations will be known to him. Next. Strategic management process. That is first process. That first identifying, defining business mission, purpose, objective. Every organization have their vision. Okay, step one. Next, step two. Environmental analysis means SWOT analysis, study of environmental analysis, that is study of your competitors. Next. Revise the organization direction. Proper analysis of organization, SWOT, helps the management in revising the organization direction. Why we are doing SWOT analysis? If you are not, what direction, that directing means going in the right direction. If you are moving in the wrong direction, what will happen? You will never reach to the destination. So it revises the organizer direction, process, strategic management. It gives the way, it navigates. The navigator is a person who is helping the pilot to fly the aircraft in the air. Likewise here, it navigates. It revises the organizer direction, gives the direction to the management. Next. Strategic alternatives and choice. Strategic alternatives means what are the various alternatives that you are finding. That is different kinds of the strategies that you have decided, and correct strategy that will be decided by the manager with his intuitions and with his subject knowledge and with his experience. Next. Strategy implementation is very important aspect. You thought 24 hours in a day, but you don't implement the things, there is no output. So the moment you go for the strategic alternative, choose analysis, after that you have to implement the things, because without implementation you can't find the change. You can't find the change in the organization. Implementation is very important. We are going to see this one by one in the next lectures. Next. Strategic evaluation and control. After evaluation, control is the function of management, manager. Evaluation means we have to find out whether desired strategy, design strategy is proved to be successful. That has to be evaluated. If it is successful, we have to go ahead. If it is not successful, then again controlling means again you have to go back to the step number one. That is analysis, choose, implementation, again come. This process is a cyclic. We have seen strategic management is a cyclic process. Till the time we are not getting up to the output, in no cost we have to leave the work. Okay. Next. Don't leave. Next stage. So this is process, strategic management process. That first is your strategy formulation, organization appraisal, that is environmental analysis, environmental observation. Then means in the first we are going for in the worst, that is strategy formulation, organization appraisal, business mission, revised business mission objective, strategic environmental analysis. It comes in first analysis part, then strategy implementation. Implementation is third part. First part, analysis and choose. Second part is implementation, and third part is evaluation. Okay, as we have seen in earlier. And feedback and feed forward. Feedback and feed forward. From here, evaluation, we are giving the feedback, and again we are going in feed forward. Means it is a cyclic process. Next. Strategic management model for contingency planning. Choose the contingency strategy implementation. Choice and implementation. Next. Analysis or choice and implementation. Next. Then strategic management small business in case of corporate strategy, that is corporate level strategy. That this part we will see in the next lecture. Okay. What is corporate strategy? What is functional strategy? What is organizational strategy? That part we'll cover in the next lectures. Okay. Till the time, what we have covered regarding strategic management process, need of strategic management. Okay. Whatever you had the doubts, you can send me your doubts on WhatsApp. Okay. Questions. In the next lecture, we will first, we will clear your doubts and we'll next go for the next. Right? Thank you very much. Those who are attended the lectures, those who are not attended the lecture, they will be getting the recording. Through the recording, if they are having any kinds of the doubts, they can come up to us. Because of some difficulties and constant of time, because Zoom lectures, we cannot conduct more than 40 minutes. So whatever we are covering, okay, if you have any kinds of the doubts, you can WhatsApp me. Don't WhatsApp on personal. WhatsApp me on my personal WhatsApp number. We'll try to give the solution to you. And today in strategic management, we will see today the topic, that is strategic management model for contingency planning. So first of all, you will have to understand what is meant by contingency. Contingency is a activity which is done generally by any department organizations when you are in the distress. Distress means when you are in the planning, when you are in the problem. So in planning, in problem, you have to make alternate strategies, or you have to plan the things, and you have to make the contingencies. Contingencies means planning in step by step, the group wise. That is called as contingency planning. Means if a target is a very big and it is very difficult to achieve, or you are facing the problems, and that time, what you have to do, you have to differentiate the goal into different segments, and that is called as contingency planning. So here you have to choose the contingency strategies. Contingency strategies means you have to choose contingency strategies, that is what is to be done by an individual. that allotment, that is, we call it such in resource allocation. Allocation of resources means you will allocate the resources as well as you will allocate the duties to them. Okay. And for that, you will be designing the different kinds of contingency strategies, how to deal in the situation. Generally, what happened, you know, that key, whenever the aircraft in the air, it is in the distress, it is in the problem. So all are making an efforts to contact with the aircraft, and we are making the aircraft to land on the ground very safely. For that, so many agencies will be involved in all kinds of activities. Likewise, here, when the problem is there, when all, right from the general manager, layman, workforce, up to general managers, everybody is getting involved in the activities. And already every company is having their activity, their strategies in dealing with the awkward situations or difficult situations. So what are the various strategies? There are different strategies, but out of that, you will choose a particular strategy to deal with the contingency, that we called it such a contingency strategy. And what we have to do again in the same formula, the strategic management process. You already analyzed, and you have only choose the strategies. And after choosing the strategies, you have to implement the strategies, means develop the medium and short range policies, plans, program for each contingency strategy. Here, the short term policies and plans, because these strategies will never work for a long time. Every organization, they are having their short term strategies, long term strategies, then medium term strategies, as well as they are having their strategies for their own functionings. They are having the plans for their own functionings. So here, in the awkward situations, what you will do, you will select the contingency strategies and implement these strategies, and these strategies are of the short-term nature. Next. Now, here in the case of a small business, how the strategic management takes place, we will see. Here, we require the corporate level strategies. Corporate level strategies means the strategies which designed or which is required to run the corporate. That is, here you have seen middle and supervisor level strategies. Corporate level strategies means will be given by the head, and middle and supervisor level strategies, how we are designing it, that marketing policies and plans, production operation management policies and plans, financial policies and plans, human resources resource policies and plan, R&D policies and plan. Means here you have seen, in order to get the synergy effect, all the departments of the organizations are getting involved, and they are having their plans, strategies in case dealing with a difficult situation, that is called as contingency. So middle level and supervisor level personals will be implementing these kind of the strategies. Next. Here we'll go one by one. Production, operation and strategic management. In case of production departments, how the strategic management takes place. Production of goods and rendering services in the organizations. Production operation manager helps strategic management process by making decisions relating to production facilities, location of factory layout, facilities layout, capacity planning, inventory and quality of goods services, scheduling and product design. See, you are already studied the subject, that is operation and supply chain management. And you know what is meant by factory, what are the various factors which is affecting on the functioning of organizations, how should be the layout of factory, smooth functioning, then capacity, planning, inventory, quality of goods, services, quality, scheduling, product design. These are various kinds of the strategies we are designing, or we can say that we are doing the strategic management in case of our productions and operation departments. Means here, for example, that suppose a military force is there, generally we have seen, we have cleared this in the earlier lecture, that strategy is a word which comes from the military origin. Military origin means when there is a normal time or peace, all are functioning with the normal plans and strategies. But when there is a war, then we are changing the strategies. Means allotting the resources, movement of troops, then SOP, standard operating procedure during the war. Likewise here, you face a problem, means it's a war. If the organization is working smoothly, there is no problem. With your normal plan strategies, you can go ahead. But if organization is facing the problem, okay, maybe internal problem or maybe the external problem, then that, in that case, what you have to do, you have to use the various strategies, that is called as strategies during the problem, that is contingency strategies. Here, whole departments of the functioning of operation departments during the normal time and during the strategic time, that is strategic means problematic time. How you are managing all these things, it must be with you. Next. Finance and strategic management. Contributions of finance manager to the strategic management include the decisions relating capital structure, capital budgeting, dividend policy, capital issue, designing different instruments for mobilizing capital, working capital management. The best example that I will give you, that COVID situations and the organizations are facing the problem during COVID. Okay. It has adversely affecting on three departments. So all the departments, so mostly I'm talking about marketing, finance and HR. During this situation, it is very difficult to make a payment to the employee. It is very difficult to get the payments from the suppliers. Then it is very difficult to get the arrange the capital, working capital. In this case, how the organizations should run and how we should manage all these things, that is called a finance and strategic management. Next. Marketing and strategic management. Marketing manager contributes their efforts in strategic management process by providing information on 4P's marketing mix analysis and 3P extended mix analysis. Apart from this, they support the process by providing information on consumer behavior and market segmentation. Okay. 4 P's, product, price, promotion and place. It is a mix, always we have to change. And extended marketing means people, process and physical evidence. So apart from these 4 P's, 4 P's will help you during strategic situation. Apart from that, marketing department of the organizations will continuously give the informations regarding consumer's behavior, market segmentation, if a new product has came in the market. Likewise, informations which is affecting on the sell of organizations will be given, and during this process, organizations will take the strategic steps. Human resource and strategic management. Contribution of human resources to the strategic management includes HR planning, formulating policies relating to recruitment, retaining, selection, training, development, performance, analysis and development, wage and salary administration, management of incentives, organizational structure, climate and development, human resource values, human relations, etc. See, human resource management and strategic human resource management. Strategic human resource management means in case of turbulence, in case of problem, how we are going to manage this organizations. Okay. That is human resource and strategic management. It has concern with each other. Next. Now, what are the very challenges being faced by the strategic management team? Technological advancement. Tech and product and service innovation. Global issues. Quality issues. technological advancements. That's what happened. Ki right now, what is going on, technological advancements, computerization is going very highly and heavily. And due to that, what happens? The small business firms, they are unable to cope up with others. So what they have to done means they will be in the problem. So they will have to plan the contingency. They will have to go for the contingency planning in order to cope up with them. See, strategic main aim of strategic management is that you have to compete with your arch rivals, competitors, or you have to gain the strategic position, advancement. So take example that before 10 years back, the computerization has started in banking sector. So these private banks, they came up with the infrastructure, physical evidence, process, people, and they started invaded in Indian territory. So what happened that most of the consumer group has been attracted toward them because of the glamour and the kinds of the services being provided by them. Now on the same time, Maharashtra Bank, State Bank, Cooperative Bank, they were not able to bring this computerization at all of a sudden. So what has happened? It has really affected on their performance. So what they have done, they have designed their corporate level strategy. Their head or their CEO, top management, has allocated the resources, we can call as funds, and they have brought the computerization and they competed with the rest of the private banks, and they have retained their position in the market. What happens because of this? Sometimes any organizations may lose their survival. I mean, they will be totally closed down, like it is happening in the Patra Samstha, Credit Cooperative Society, because they can't afford this much of challenges and this much of money which is required funds. So they start their survival is very difficult. But you have seen that the state banks, national banks, still they are managed and still they are functioning and they are providing at par services. That is called as technological advancement, products and service innovation. Same tech example of banking sector. They are also innovated the various products, services. Earlier bank was built for what? Bank was built for only keeping your deposits, saving on current accounts. But now you have seen bank is giving house finance, bank is giving gold finance, bank is giving education loan, bank is giving travel tourism loan, bank is giving agricultural loan. Means for in every sector, bank has developed enormously their products. That is called an innovation. And this is required. This is required in order to sustain yourself. Strategic management, the role of strategy is to survive the organizations. And I told you in the beginning itself that who survives? Neither strongest nor intelligent. Who survives? Who makes the changes? So hence you find that in the current era, you find a lot of changes and reformations. Restructuring means this organization has changed their shapes, organization changed their functioning. Marketing, you find that a lot of companies are doing marketing, means online marketing. Now in case of human resource management, because of this COVID, this contingency strategy that we are using, that work from home, means human resources, they are working from home. Physical attendance is not required. And students, where they have to attend the lectures, now what they are doing, they are attending the online lectures. Okay. So these are the challenges, global issues. Global issues means issues relating to the world. It is very difficult to reach out to the global organizations. For that, organization has to spare the fund and they have to develop the infrastructure. We have seen that now our Bank of Maharashtra, State Bank of India, they are having their international operations. Earlier it was very difficult for them to go in the international market, but Now, State Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra, they are operating worldwide. That is globalization, quality issues, total quality management, social issues, total quality management. TQM is a practice in operations management. Total quality management is a tool for what? Quality, maintaining the quality. Social issues, organizing is the part and parcel of the society. Mission of any organization based on society. Social responsibility is the management obligation, production organizations and society's interest. What after all, at the end we'll find that what for the organizations are functioning, they are having the social vision and social mission in order to cater the need of society. We are going to see all these things in our next lecture, that is vision and mission. Vision and mission of the organizations has to be socially inclined. It must be inclined with the society. Social inclination is required because we are working for the society. Hence, you find you get the vision and mission of any organizations. You will find they are working for the benefit of society. That is called the social issues. Means you have to work for the customers.